All right. So there are four required state labs according to New York State. The first one we already did, it's called diffusion across the membrane. That's the one that had two parts with a red onion cell, salt water and regular water, and making a cell using starch and glucose to see how those diffuse. The second one is making connections. We're not going to be doing the whole part of it. We'll be doing parts, most of it though. Tyler, you had a question? And the third and fourth one are going to be in the spring. So we're going to start it today. We're going to finish it on Wednesday. Friday, we're going to do a bunch of practice questions from our notebook. And your exam three is going to be on Monday. You guys have school Tuesday. You won't have living Tuesday, though. And your Thanksgiving recess is 3 days, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So you'll see me Monday, but then you won't see me again till Monday, November 30th. Oh. I believe. Yep. What? Yes. All right. So we're almost done with this unit. And this unit doesn't have lots of notes with it. It's just random like activities like with diabetes and regulation and this lab today. So moving on, raising your hand. Can someone tell me what is pulse rate? What is pulse rate? All right, Tyler. Blood movement through your body. Oh, okay. What else? Gage, were you raising your hand?
Yeah. Like what Tyler said, it's the blood rate, but it, the blood rate is going like from your heart. It's how we measure heartbeat.
It's how you measure heartbeat. All right. What else? Cody? The rate at which blood flows through your body. Okay. What else? There, I thought you guys would want to see them.
Yeah. Hello, friends.
They can't see you.
Put your hand down.
All right, what else, Anthony?
I have a question.
Yeah.
Is there a lab report for this Band-Aid lab?
It's not one, like a formal lab report. It's just to fill in the blank stuff. Okay. So, yeah. All right. So for the most part, you guys got it. So what I want you guys to do, your remote students, I emailed you the packet that we're going to be doing today. So please check, open up your email. I'm going to pass this out.
Maybe what I think I'll do instead is I'll get another computer, set it up here like on a desk.
I don't have it.
So it just stares at you guys the whole time, or like leave it up here so we can see you and they can still see me. Yeah. And it's like another student. Does anybody here need a packet?
All right. So remote students, I emailed you this. I emailed you guys this. This right here. So if you could open it up right here, you're just going to click on file, make a copy, and you can just add your initials, like erase this part, copy, and then you can just add your initials like Anthony Manicha to it, Alan Tubman to it, or you can just type in Alan, whatever. I'm okay with it. Or you can just save it without a name, but make sure when you have to share it with me. Type in my name so I have access to it. And you're going to have wfreeze@citybosies.net. Okay, make sure you share it with me. All right, so that's how what I do with you guys. If you're ever not here, I will send you guys like a virtual version of it. And it's really not that different from this version. And then you guys are going to plug in your answers. So right here, make sure you guys just put your name with like Alan Tubman or Mariah James, whatever your name is, just erase this. All right, so we all have the same packet in front of us. So making connections. What? Someone had a question?
I never got it. I never got it.
You didn't? I never sent it to you? Oh, you know what? You're right. I might have missed you on the email. Hold on. Does anybody else in here not get it? What's your legitimate question? Oh my goodness, I forgot about you in the email. You're right. Am I missing anybody else? I sent it to Aiden, McKee, William, Brian, Vincent, Mariah, Aiden, Lily, and Alan. Am I forgetting anybody? Forward it to...
I shared it to you, so my variation to you.
Okay, no, is there somebody who didn't get this, the document in the first place? Sorry, Anthony. All right, now you should have it. All right, so moving on. As they make observations, scientists are always looking for patterns in the natural world. For instance, researchers have observed that pregnant women who smoke cigarettes have a higher incidence of low birth weight babies, and that people with high fat diets have a greater risk of developing heart disease. 140. Discovering and explaining connections is one of the basic methods by which our knowledge of the world advances. Sometimes the connections are not what we expect or would predict, and sometimes we may have a hard time explaining the connections. Nevertheless, this is how science makes progress. In this part of the laboratory activity, you will make a few observations about yourself and your classmates, then you will look for patterns or connections. So, what is a pulse rate? Your pulse is a result of expansion of blood vessels that occurs each time your heart beats to send a surge of blood through your body. You can feel certain blood vessels pulse as this happens. Two different ways to make your own pulse rate are illustrated below. Choose the one that works best for you. As you press lightly, you should feel the pulsing of the blood. If you cannot locate your pulse rate after a short time, ask your teacher for help. So guys, either your left hand or your right hand doing it this way, another way would be to place it right here or right here. So I want everybody, including you remote students, to find your pulse rate right now. If you can't get it here, please ask me for help. Also, don't use your thumb. Does anybody say why? Does anybody know I'm saying don't use your thumb? Maddie? Correct. Your thumb has a pulse to it too. So either here. I can feel it here or here. And then if you look at my wrist or some people are trying way too low, it usually works here or here. What is your question, Tom?
What's the average heart rate for a human heart rate?
Pulse rate? Oh, Vincent and Aiden, sorry, I just saw your message. Yeah, I definitely said that. If you can turn your video and audio off or anything, especially if it's causing your internet connection to go slower, yes, turn it off. I wouldn't want to interrupt you. Like if you can keep your on and you can afford it, but please keep your camera on if you can. Obviously, if it just slows your internet connection down, turn it off. Like I wouldn't want that. So either here or here. All right. Raise your hand if you're having trouble finding it. Anybody online? Anybody remotely having trouble finding it?
Yeah.
Oh, Anthony? What? Oh, you're good? Okay. All right. So this is what we're going to do. If we're looking at the worksheet in front of you guys, it says your pulse rate is a measure of how many times a minute your heart beats. Count the number of pulses you can feel in 20 seconds. So it's how many times a minute. So what do we have to multiply that number by? Figure out in 60 seconds.
Yep.
Three. Record this number below and then multiply it by three to determine how many times your heart beats in 60 seconds. Wait a minute and measure your pulse again. Wait another minute and measure your pulse a third time. So we're gonna do three trials. So everybody go ahead and find your pulse rate. Go ahead and find it. Yeah, I'm going to put the timer on my phone. Only because sometimes what's happened in the past, I've always put a timer on the screen, but when I do that, students end up paying attention to the number on the screen as opposed to the sound. So I'm gonna go ahead and put my timer on for 20 seconds. So when I tell you to start, you start counting how many times you feel your pulse. And when you hear the sound go off, you stop. Ready, set, start. Go ahead and place that number right here. Okay, that number could be 17, could be 35, could be 20.
20.
Okay, so whatever number you get, you're gonna multiply it by 3. You don't need a calculator for this, but I mean, you need one, but.
I mean, people might use it to be lazy though.
That's true. So I'm gonna have, would someone want to share what number they got just from counting it to 20 seconds?
26 yes. Beats per minute.
Right. So Alan, you got 26. So 26, all right, times 3. I'm gonna show you guys how to do math in case you forgot. 6 times 3 is what? 6. Thank you. One person knows what 6 times 3 is. So it's 18. Put down the 8. Carry the 1. 3 times 2 is 6. Plus 1 is 78. So it's 78. So trial 1. Alan will write down 78 right here. So for you remote students, what you guys can do is you can erase these like numbers. They're not called hashtags. What are they called?
Signs.
No, they're not.
Pound signs.
Thank you. Yeah, you can put you can erase those and put your numbers there. Huh? No. All right, we're gonna go ahead and do it for trial 2. So everybody, get ready because we're about to do trial 2. No. All right, ready, set, start. All right, so that number right there, this is for trial 2. You're gonna place that number here, multiply it by 3, and place that number right here. Okay?
I got 35.
So then you're gonna do 35 times 3. Vincent, do you only have classes and issues in this class or your other classes? Because if so, I can get you a hotspot maybe Wednesday and drop it off at your house if you're having.
It's not about the Wi-Fi. My Wi-Fi is great. It's about the Chromebook itself is being stupid.
That doesn't make any sense. Do you need a new Chromebook? Should I get you a new one?
Oh, Chrome don't have a lot of CPU, so they don't really do my thing and Zoom meeting at the same time.
Because I don't think other kids.
Yeah, they don't work very well.
I agree. Chromebooks are really bad for Zoom. I was like, I'd like it if you would just stay in class so you could follow along. But I do recording. Yes.
Yeah. I couldn't hear once. There was a time I couldn't hear what I was trying to, like, the work we're doing class, but still.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. I have a really good Chromebook. I mean, a really good, like,
laptop. All right, it's okay. I believe you. I believe you. All right, let's go do trial three. So, got it. I believe you. I mean, okay. Trial three, everybody. Go ahead, find your pulse rate for the third time. Ready?
No.
I want to make sure we're all ready. So, ready, set. Nope, we're still waiting for somebody. Ready, set, start. All right. So go ahead, write that number down, multiply it by three. Now, if you look right here, it says your pulse rate should be about the same each time. For accuracy, it is often better to take two or three readings about a minute apart and average them. So calculate and record your average pulse rate. So somebody raise your hand, tell me, how can I calculate the average for this? Gage?
Add each of your heart rates together and divide them by three.
Why by three?
Because you did three trials.
Because we did three trials. Good. So take this number here. Yes. Take this number here and take this number here. Add them all up and divide by three because we did three trials. In the last class, someone said divided by three because we multiplied it by three, and that's not true. It's the amount of trials. Okay.
If we get a decimal, what place do you want us to round to?
The 10th place. Just round, yeah, the 10th place. Yeah. All right. So, can I say this? Everybody every year screws this up, so let's go ahead and try this. So, what I want you guys to do, and this is going to be a little tricky, because I have, but I'm going to put all your screens up. So, William, you're going to have to type this in the box, or Aiden's going to have to, and everybody else is going to have to raise your hand. Everybody always screws this up every year. So on the next page, it says, complete a data table. Use the average pulse rate for each student in the class to complete the data table below. Class results. So there's six different categories, less than 51, 51 to 60 average, 61 to 70 average, and so on and so forth. So, and I'm going to be counting both of you guys, both virtual and in person at the same time. So raise your hand if you got an average pulse rate of less than 51. Remote students too, make sure you raise your hand if you got that. Not necessarily. Okay. Hold on. What is going on? All right. Raise your hand if you got an average pulse rate between 51 and 60. Anthony. All right, so just one student. Raise your hand. Oh, hold on. I'm getting the chat box. Raise your hand if you got an average pulse rate between 61 and 70. Zero. Okay. Raise your hand if you got an average pulse rate between 71 and 80. One, two, three, four. Just Mariah. Okay. Raise your hand if you got an average pulse rate between 81 and 90. One, two, three, four, Okay. So you didn't raise your hand?
I'm 98.
Huh?
But I
wait, what? Okay. Raise your hand if you got a pulse rate higher than 90.
You know what I think it is? I like to bounce my foot up and down.
And William, right? Ellen, what did you raise your hand for? Maybe I missed it because I gotta go back.
I've missed the 71 to 80. Then you said 81 to 90. I raised my hand for that, but then I'm wait, this is 81. I missed the one I was in, 71 to 80.
All right, so let me go to this. As long as we could fix it instead of doing a recount, then that should be fine. All right, so Tristan, you're supposed to be right here, right? And Alan and William, I think I put you in here because you've got 96. And yep. Alan Tubman, you're accidentally here.
I raised my hand for 81. I should be in 71.
Okay, so this should be 3. And that should be 5. All right, so we have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 students in person. And 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. We have a total of 17 students, right? Because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 virtual, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Do these add up to 17?
No, 16. I'm not
on there. Oh, you're not on there? Where are you supposed to be? The rightmost one? Okay. 6. All right, this is what it should say. So now it's correct. So remember when I said at the beginning of class, no, not every class. I've never had a class that gets this right the first time. And it's because every time we've gone through this and I put on the tally marks, the numbers that we have in students never equals the number here. Every class, every year, because sometimes they forget or they're raising their hands twice. They raise their hand for the wrong one, which it happens, but I've never had a class get it right the first time. I forgot to tell you guys, don't write the data down because students mess up and that's okay. But there it is. So you should have all this data written down. So now prepare a histogram. Use the information in the data table to prepare a histogram of the class results. Use the grid below, provide a title for the histogram, label the vertical axes and mark an appropriate scale on the vertical axes. When you have determined the height of each column, shade in the vertical bars. So let's give this title, let's give this histogram a title. So raising your hand, what should be the title of this? Not always. This one, there's not, because there's no necessary relationship between it. It's a histogram. So a histogram isn't necessarily, Aiden, put it away, showing a relationship between things. And you too, Tyler, put that away. You don't need it. It's not, a histogram doesn't necessarily show you relationship between each way. They show you the amount in each category. So on the x-axis, we have average pulse rate range. So the title could be student. Let's see. Why is that not working? Hold on, guys. Oh, oopsie, I forgot to do it there. Yeah. Hold on. There we go. So, student average pulse rate. And I knew you remote students can't write this down on the left side, but what's my vertical axis going to be labeled? Yeah. Number of students. All right. My remote students, what you guys can do is you can double click on the drawing and I'll show it for you guys and you can do this. So what's my highest number that I got within the category?
Tyler? No, the highest number of students that I got in the category.
Yeah, six. So let's see. One, two, three, four, five, six. Perfect. Okay, it's better to spread it out, but how many students got less than 51?
Yeah.
How many students got between 51 and 60?
One.
How many between 61 and 70?
One.
All right, you guys get how to do this? For my remote students, what you guys can do, and I'll show you how to do it, and if you guys want to look online in case you need, you want to know how to do it, hold on, Tyler. Here, Tyler, let me go over this with you. Clear. So if you remote students look at my screen really quick, I'm gonna double click on this. And I've usually try to make pictures or graphs like this, so you guys can do it. So if I click on this one right here, and I click on shapes, and I click on this square right here, between 51 and 60, there was one. And I'm just gonna do that and like use this paint bucket to fill it in red. Between 51 and 60, what was the number, guys?
We can't write on the sides, so just so you know.
Oh, that's okay. But you can do it by doing a text box. It's a little tricky, so I'm not too concerned about it. Like, if you can't get it, it's okay. That's why I said you wouldn't be able to probably do the title page, but you could probably do this part. And
didn't no one get a resting heart rate below 51?
Yeah, that's what I was
saying. Ignore me. Then yes, you're probably right. Yeah, I wasn't looking at my data.
That's a very crucial part.
What's 90? 90 was six, right? One, two, three, four, five, six.
Ooh, that's large.
So I'm not going to look at it. Can I see yours real quick, Tristan? So I'm going to show you guys what Tristan looks like, because I'm hoping it's accurate because I'm not looking at it. But everybody should be like a general trend like this. You guys see it too? It should, for the most part, it should look like this. Okay. All right. So now, don't ask me when we're taking a break. I promise we will be taking one. Now it says answer the following questions. So, and I just want to go over this in case we have to go remote, guys, but for virtual students too. So what you guys have in front of you is you guys have a question in front of you, and you guys have a space for your answers, right? When I give you guys an online copy, I don't put in lines, because the lines that should guide you. Yeah, but the lines in there, they're just underlines, and you can't even write over them. You have to like erase them, and it's annoying. So now I create a text box, and you can just type in your answers here. So do you see a pattern in the class data? Raise your hand. Look at your things. You guys see patterns, any patterns in your class data? Kristen says no. All right.
Some of us are very inactive.
I'm very
Yes.
I think there's no pattern.
Why not?
Because there's not a large enough data set to really tell.
All right. So, yeah. So, Alaric says no, and it's because there is not enough data to really see a pattern. Okay. There is not enough data to really see the pattern. On the next page, you have number two. A question that someone might ask about pulse rate is there a connection between height and pulse rate? Based on information obtained from this activity, can you tell if there's a connection between a person's height and the person's average pulse rate? Raising your hand, A and B. Can you tell, based on this information obtained, can you tell if there's a connection between a person's height and the person's average pulse rate? Why not? But you don't know that.
Well, wouldn't you need a higher pulse rate if you're
smaller? But you wouldn't know. Hold on. But you don't know that. So you're right that the answer is no, but not your why. Andrew?
No, because that's not what the data shows. The data doesn't reflect anything about that.
Correct. Yeah. No, because no data was collected on students' height.
Miss Ruiz?
Yeah.
That editing, the thing that you double-clicked it to edit the picture, the graph?
Yeah.
It isn't working for me, and I edit, like, at all. It's showed up, it does something totally different, where I don't have any options to edit it, and I have to...
That's okay, then.
Having to close out of the doc.
Oh, okay. That's okay, then. Don't worry about that part. And it says, what additional data would you need? You'd actually need to collect students' height. Number three, what is another question that someone might ask about the pulse rate that could be answered by doing an experiment? What is another question that someone might ask that could be answered by doing an experiment? Ashley, Hayden, Hayden Lilly, Hayden McKee, Maddie. Does athleticism affect pulse rate? What's another one that someone could ask? Gage?
Does weight affect pulse rate?
Does weight affect pulse rate? Good. Does gender, Aiden Lilly asked, does gender have anything to do with it? Alan Tubman. What heart rate increase as you are more active? Does gender affect it? Does physical activity? All right. Yes. All right, I'm cutting my words short. Okay, yes, Tyler? What? All right, good. So we came up with a bunch of one. Number four. Some people have suggested that someone's pulse rate will increase if he or she becomes more active. Try this. Once you have found your resting pulse rate, which we already did, run in place for 1 minute as an alternate. Okay, so you guys don't have this on your paper, but do you guys see where it says, let us calculate the increased pulse rate? I want you guys to add this because I forgot to. So the remote students have this, but you guys don't have it. Write this down. Write down your average pulse rate, which we calculated on the first page. And then listen to me. Right now, we're all going to take a mask break. We are all going to go outside. We're all going to spread out over here, here, here. Do not step on the grass. Do not step on the puddles. You take off your masks. Spread 6 feet apart, and you guys are each going to be doing jumping jacks, and I expect you remote students to do the same thing. And you remote students, yes, Tyler? You can do knee bends. Is there something that you can do?
Yeah.
Or Ashley too, sorry. If you have like injuries, if you really can't do something, please don't do it, because I don't want you guys getting injured further and like getting sued.
I can't do the physical activity yet.
That's okay. Well, all right. Thank you, William. So, William and Tyler. William, you're definitely exempt. Tyler and Ashley, if you really can't do it, that's okay. I can't probably. Don't, no. You just said, I can probably. You're not doing it. You know what you can do? Can you just walk back and forth then? I'm sorry. You're not injuring yourself in my class. Come here. Nope. We're all going to be doing unless
what doesn't kill you make what doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
I agree, Ellen. Unless you're William, Tyler, or Ashley, you're all doing jumping jacks for 1 minute. Corbin. Yeah, I know. But we're yes. But none of us have any issues that can stop us do it. Do you want me to do it with you? I'll smell, but I'll do it if you want me to, because I sweat really bad. Okay, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to go outside. I'm going to record you guys doing it. Oh, I'm not going to record. I'm going to put my timer on for 1 minute. As soon as my phone goes off, I'll yell at you to go off. Don't talk. Try not to laugh. Try catching your breath. Find your pulse rate right away, because we're going to measure it for 20 seconds. Remember that number, because then we're going to come in and fill out this worksheet, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put you guys here. I won't be taking you guys with me. I'm sorry. So you guys can do it afterwards. Actually, I would like it if you guys wait a couple minutes to do it so I can get a picture of you guys doing it. So let's go outside. 1 minute. You're a minute of exercising now. It's only fair. So stand up. This is how you still get the same experience. Okay, hold on. All right. So I'm going to record. I'm going to not record you. Sorry. I'm going to time you guys. Ready? Set. Start. Keep going. Keep going.
Oh, dude. This is beautiful. You gotta get over your head. Over the head, Aunt. Yeah, hands over the head.
This is beautiful. Aiden's like morphing.
Keep going.
Hands turning into, yeah, morphing. Aiden literally
is going so fast, she's turning into a...
Bro, you're
making
a speed light.
It's
flying,
bro.
It's flying, bro.
Aiden,
you're morphing, bro.
Keep going. You're almost done. All right, they need silence so they can find their heart rate in a second. Stop. All right, stop really quickly. Shh. Find your heart rate. Shh. Guys, they need silence so they can concentrate. Right. All right, ready, set, start counting now. All right, multiply that number by 3 and write down. Great job, everybody. So right now you should have here, number 4, you should have written this down in red because you guys don't have that in your worksheet. Average pulse rate, which you guys calculated on the first page, and that and then your average pulse rate after exercise, well, not your average, but your pulse rate after exercise. All right.
That's interesting. So I knew you would force us to do jumping jacks. So I wanted to conduct my own experiment.
Okay.
When you guys went out, I went out to the side and ran for a minute straight. I used my own phone to time it.
Okay.
My heart rate went from 77.3 to 114 when I was running. And then when I did jumping jacks, it went to 147.
Huh. Interesting.
Mine went from 96 to 63.
That makes sense, William. Aiden Lilly, you guys can't see his comment, but he said he had to try to not hit his ceiling. Same for Aiden McKee. All right, so for number 5. So, what? No. I can see that. All right, number 5 said, Ray, Corbin, what was your average pulse rate and what was yours after exercise?
104 and then
138. 104, then 138. Aiden Lilly, what was yours? Okay. Aiden Lilly's was 81, then 141. Gage, what was yours?
So quick thing, I did the first test again because in the first two, in the original one, I bounced my foot up and down before the first two.
Uh-huh.
So I did that again, and my average heart rate went down from about 108 to 78.
Okay.
And after the exercise, it was 135.
135. All right. What about yours, Tristan?
It was 69.
69 and 159. Okay. So for the most part, unless little things happen or if we weren't actually exercising, pulse rate increased for most people. Why? Explain why this connection between pulse rate and activity makes sense. Raise your hand. Why do you think there's a connection between pulse rate and physical activity? Andrew?
Because you're using more oxygen, so your blood needs to transport that oxygen.
Okay.
So
during activity, people need more oxygen. To get more oxygen, your blood, what'd you say? Needs to travel faster. Okay, good. Does anybody have write this down. All right, so Andrew just shared his answer and I wrote it up. Does anybody have something else to say or something different to say or add? Elaborate on? Okay. Number 6. During, let me move your hand real quick, Tristan. All right. Remote students, I actually cut this box in, so I'm just gonna copy it and paste it right here again, and I'll delete the, oh. Control C, let's see, it'll work. Yep, all right, during exercise, what two body systems are working closely together and how? I'm thinking about two in particular. During exercise, that's number six, right? Which two body systems are working closely together and how? So Alan Tubman says circulatory delivers oxygen and respiratory uses oxygen. Good. I'm going to add a little bit more backwards. So, well, he mentioned the correct one. So circulatory delivers oxygen to parts of the body that need it. While respiratory receives the oxygen. What else? All right, write this down, then we'll elaborate. What else is the circulatory system doing, though? Or what else is the respiratory system doing besides receiving the oxygen? It is also getting rid of carbon dioxide. So the circulatory system delivers oxygen to parts of the body that needs it, while the respiratory both receives the oxygen and gets rid of carbon dioxide. So write this part down and we can move on to the next part. No, we're going to finish it tomorrow in class. There are some that you will do, but we're not done yet. Wednesday, thank you. So the next part, how does fatigue affect muscle performance? A condition known as muscle fatigue occurs when certain waste products of muscle cell activity build up in the cells. Until these muscle cell chemicals are removed, the fatigue will continue. I want you guys to write this down in big letters. Lactic acid is a waste that builds up, and only more oxygen will remove it. Write this down somewhere around there. Lactic acid is a waste that builds up and only more oxygen will remove it. So when you guys go to gym class or when you guys were outside doing a whole minute of jumping jacks, did anybody feel like any soreness in your body?
I did.
All right, you did?
I feel
soreness in my shoulder every minute of every day.
I'm sorry.
My shoulder's in pain constantly.
From what? Have you seen a doctor about it?
I don't know.
All right, so the soreness that you guys feel is something called muscle fatigue. So when you're haven't exercised in a while, or you're doing strenuous exercise, or you haven't exercised, you're exercising for too long, you start feeling fatigue more than like the average, like first minute when you're like out of breath. And that's because there's a certain waste product building up in your cells. And that waste product is called lactic acid, the waste product. The only way to get rid of lactic acid is to bring in more oxygen. So our body responds by breathing harder and faster because you're trying to pump more oxygen in. More oxygen, but at the same time, you're also breathing, you're exercising more. You're trying to get rid of carbon dioxide. So it's a lactic acid waste buildup, need more oxygen. So you breathe harder, faster to get more oxygen. Until those waste chemicals are removed, the fatigue will continue. So it says right here, and I forgot to email this part to you, Anthony, I'm sorry. Hold a spring tight clothespin between your thumb and index finger. Pinch the ends together completely until the ends touch and release them. Do this as rapidly as possible for 1 minute. Record the number of times you could squeeze a clothespin in 1 minute. So unfortunately, I forgot to bring in a clothespin. But what I did bring is I found binder clips, and I think I emailed you guys. Or if you have a clothespins you can get by, or you could just try this activity later on your own. I have these binder clips. So I'm going to give you guys each one of these. They look like this. You can just open them up to do this. So you're not going to be able to have these two ends right here touch at the same time because it's, look how hard it is too. I'd probably like break it. That's as far as I don't try doing it because I don't want you breaking it. So what I want you guys to do is when you get one, you're going to open it by just like this much, like your finger or pinky can fit in. It doesn't need to be a lot. Don't do that because you're going to be in a lot of pain. So if you have a clothespin, use a clothespin. You have a binder clip, use that just enough so like a finger can fit in there. But don't put your finger in there. And that's as far as you're going to open it. And you're going to count how many times you could do it in a minute. Right? Okay. So go ahead and pass one out to each.
I feel like I should put my finger in
it. Yeah. Oh, I
No,
the thing is just to show you guys how wide it's opening should be. Yeah.
I found a video of a super cross, and apparently in qualifying, their heart rate is 90% more than an average heart rate match.
Really?
Yeah. When they're just doing qualifying, not even the big races. And not even the spikes.
Okay, I never said it was safe.
I put my finger.
Where's the pound rep?
I did the thing. I put my finger in it. Right? I don't want it.
I'm
going to
click this one.
Whoa, don't be under me.
Ah.
I guess you need to hurry
up. All right. I'm going to go ahead and put my timer on for 1 minute. Ready? You're going to count how many times you could open it and close it. I mean, only do it like a whip length. Yes. All right. Ready? Not all the way. You're only using your thumb and your pointer finger. Ready? No. You gotta use your thumb and your pointer finger. Okay. No, it's not like him. Ready? Set. Start. Shh. Count in your head.
All
right, go ahead and write that number down.
A minute.
Oh, okay.
I got 200.
All right, so everybody write that down. Oh, crap, where is it? Where am I? Oh, right here. Put that number down right here. Now it says this, try this activity again, doing it the same way and using the same two fingers as before. Record the numbers of times you could squeeze the clothespins the second time. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna set my timer. Go ahead and set my timer. Ready? Let's see. Ready, set, start. Count on your head. All right, stop.
I got 160. I dropped it. I pushed my face over, but I got 200 again.
So write that down.
My number went down.
My number went up.
Bro, I'm my number went up extremely.
Oh, yeah. I
have 240
now.
Same here.
Yeah, mine went from 162 to 194, so.
Mine went from 120 to 100.
My number dropped. My number dropped.
Oh, really? That makes sense. It's like how you're practicing. All right, where am I at? All right, so right here, guys. So now we're going to answer these questions on the next page. Oh, same page. Some people are able to squeeze the clothespins more times in a minute than others. Suggest a possible explanation for this. Why do you think that is? Why do you think some of you guys, all right, some students may be used to using these movements more often, such as in video games. All right, I'll take it.
Hand sweating. If you have sweatier hands, you really can't hold on to this thing, and it goes flying across your room over and over again.
Okay. Some may have sweaty hands and can't hold on to it for too long. What else, Tyler? Okay. Yeah, definitely. Alaric? Some students, the size of hand could affect it. Okay. Good. This one right here. I want you guys to do this one on your own, because most of this packet, pretty straightforward. We're talking about the answers, Tyler Gage. We're also discussing it, but I want you guys to do this one right here. Could you do this as many times a minute the second time as you could do the first time? Write down yes or no. And provide a biological explanation for these results. You guys are writing this down, at least made two sentences. Could you do this as many times a minute the second time as you could do the first? Write down yes or no. And provide a biological explanation for these results. This is one of the questions that I will be grading it. So don't share it. So by biological explanation, I mean use the words fatigue, use the words muscle, use the word lactic acid, oxygen, whatever you think you can think of. All right.
Wait, but what about those of us who overcame the odds and got more the first time?
Why do you think you could? That's fine. Why do you think you could?
Or sorry, more the second time than we did the first time.
That's okay. It's very common to do that too. I always get students who do that. So why do you think the explanation is for that?
Because we can. Because we believe we can.
Let's find a biological explanation. Write this down so nobody steals your answer. All right, write this down. Tyler, you should be writing down the answer for this one. You too, Tristan. A thorough answer.
Also, it has been scientifically proven that determination could force people to go above and beyond.
That is true. Yes. Hey, hold on. Yeah. Yes. Okay, I will be grading this one. Take another minute, because then we got to move on.
Determination made me be able to make swords out of wood.
All right, so add some more words besides determination. Don't tell me out loud. Write your answer, because I will be grading it. All right, so right here, what does an increased pulse rate indicate about the heart rate and flow of blood in someone's body? Raising your hand or just saying it, because I'm not looking at you guys. So if you Well, students ever need to talk, just you have to say it because I don't always have your screens up. So what does an increased pulse rate indicate about the heart rate and the flow of blood in someone's body?
An increased heart rate indicates... Oh, okay, sorry. No, when you looked away, something, I thought that you just didn't...
I heard you.
Yeah. No, I was going to say, it indicates that someone is either has just come off of an exercise or is actually less active, because I looked up what the average heart rate is, and it actually says more athletic people have a resting heart rate that's lower than average. That's lower than 51.
Or is what?
Or doesn't exercise a lot.
All right, good. So if they have just exercised, what does that mean? Alaric? Yeah. Exercise means more oxygen is required to keep muscles moving. Okay. Sometimes, yeah, athletes have more mitochondria because mitochondria releases energy. Good. Two, when muscle cells are active, cells use nutrients and oxygen at a higher rate and produce waste chemicals. What are those waste chemicals called, anybody?
Lactic acid.
Describe how the interaction of two or more body systems helps to maintain homeostasis during periods of high muscle activity. I don't want your answer. What? Carbon dioxide and water. So two main things I want you guys to get from this. Respiratory. I know. Circulatory. I want you guys to be more specific about how the respiratory and circulatory system work together. You're writing two sentences on the respiratory system, how it works to maintain homeostasis, and two sentences on the circulatory system and how, what it does to maintain homeostasis during times of exercise. Think about the words lactic acid, oxygen, carbon dioxide, energy, ATP. When your body brings in that oxygen and that glucose to release ATP, what is that process called? Cellular respiration, you're bringing in oxygen, you're bringing in glucose, you're releasing carbon dioxide and energy in the form of ATP for your body to use. Use all those words, lungs, homeostasis, balance, lactic acid. Two good sentences on respiratory and two good sentences on the circulatory system, because I will be grading that. When you are done, then you may bring your packet up here. Remote students, we're done for the day. Please make sure if you haven't already, actually I'll tell you right now if you've shared it with me or not, to please share your document with me. I've only have it from Vincent, Anthony, Aiden, William, Alan Tubman, Aiden Lilly, William, Aiden McKee, Anthony, and Vincent have shared this lab packet with me. So I'm still waiting for a couple of you guys to share it with me. But that's it for today.